सो गुड इवनिंग ऑल. जस्ट माई नेम इज विवेक सिंह, करेंटली वर्किंग विद सेमी कंडक्टर, एनएक्सपी सेमी कंडक्टर, एंड प्रोफेशनली आई एम अ टेक्निकल ग्रेजुएट. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द जीएसएस, इन जीएसएस आई एम अ चैप्टर लीडर फॉर डेली एनसीआर एंड असिस्टिंग कर्नल अशोक प्रभाकर, हु इज द चैप्टर लीडर एंड मेंटर फॉर जीएसएस नॉर्थ चैप्टर. सो एज पार्ट ऑफ जीएसएस हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस ड्राइव, टूडे टूडे इज अ टेक्निकल ट्यूजडे. सो वी यू नो दैट टूडे वी हैव इन्वाइटेड डॉक्टर सी एम भगत. आर यू एबल टू हेयर मी ना जितिन?
Yes, loud and clear, Vivek.
Okay, very good. Thank you. So I'll give a short introduction about Mr. Bhagat. So Mr. C.M. Bhagat is an MBBS MD from AIIMS, has a range of interest hobbies like excursions, gardening, agriculture, and human psychology, photography, nature, etc. Poetry writing has been the last edition in this, generally Hindi, sometime in English. Some Hindi ones have been translated into English. Poem generally revolves around human behavior and its repercussion. So as you all know that right now there are a lot of things going regard to the vaccination part. So as you know that vaccination, people are very having a confusion about the vaccination. So Mr. Bhagat will now share some important fact about the vaccination, just like type of vaccination. You know that as of now in India there are three type of vaccination is going: Covishield, Covaxin, and Sputnik. So Dr. Bhagat will give more information and right knowledge about types of vaccination. Secondly, nowadays people are also confused about the frequency of vaccine. Initially, the frequency between first dose and second dose was different, and now the frequency has been revised by the government and health department. So he'll give more information about the frequency also. And thirdly, about the Dr. Bhagat will also give the more knowledge about the precaution that has to be taken care after post vaccination. So welcome Dr. Bhagat, over to you sir.
Fine, thank you. Can I have right sir?
Yes sir.
So thank you everybody for attending this session, and I'll try to share as much knowledge as feasible with you people. Mr. Vivek rightly mentioned that we have three types of vaccines in India at the moment, out of which two are available. Third is as yet not available. The dates have been changing. 20th June, they have said it will come in the market. So let us wait for that. But the two vaccines which have been there for quite some time now, one is Covishield and other is Covaxin. Both are double dose vaccines. That means you have to take two doses to have this. Now let us understand first the basics of what is vaccine. Vaccine is inducing the body immunity against a particular invader. So in these cases, what has been done in this particular virus, that portions of the protein of the virus, whether a live virus or a dead virus, has been taken to induce, to make a vaccine. And this vaccine, when injected into the human body, it induces a reaction which leads to antibody formation. Now, this antibody gives you protection against the immunity. Now, different types of vaccines, they give you different type of reaction, and the reaction varies from person to person also. It's not that a particular dose will lead you to a particular level of immunity in all cases. So it is dependent on our body response also, that how much antibodies we develop. Dosage is given in the same dose to all the persons. So that is not the thing, but yes, type of vaccine does make a difference, and that is something to be noted, and that is something which will make us decide what can happen in a particular vaccination drive. Now, as I said, these antibody levels are formed, and generally the antibody process starts within a week or so of the injection of the vaccine, but it peaks after a certain time. And it is when the peak is there, we give a second dose. And at the same time, since the immunity from this particular vaccine is not lifelong, that means it is there for a certain period. So we have to find the ideal time when we have to give the second dose. So out of the two vaccines which we have, one is Covaxin, where we have found that the peak immunity is somewhere around 4 to 6 weeks. That means in case of Covaxin, we recommend, as of now, the Government of India recommendation is that you take the second dose after 4 to 6 weeks. Whereas in case of Covishield, they found that the peak lasts for up to 3 months or more. So that is why this recommendation is there that you take the second dose after that, so that the immunity lasts for a year or so, or at least more than the maximum possible period, the immunity is there. What happens after that, we still don't know. We are still working on it. The medical field is working on it. Sputnik, we have no experience, but yes, the theoretical experience is that two doses of two different types of variants are given. And a third type also is coming in the market. Let's wait for that. So the action of this is to form antibodies. And antibodies, as I said, they vary from person to person. Now, what is the best time to take the vaccine? Best time to take the vaccine is as soon as you are eligible for it, you get an appointment, and don't go for window shopping too much, because with the scarcity and ticking time, you see, we were all delaying our vaccination. Let us come to the ground level. We were all delaying our vaccination in the first phase, and suddenly the second phase of the COVID came, and it came with a bang. Everybody was taken by surprise, and we had so many deaths. So why should we allow another opportunity to this vaccine to make us suffer? So take the vaccine as early as possible without thinking much, whichever is available to you, easily available. And whenever you get an appointment at the place of your choice, go and take the vaccine. Not much delay, because all the vaccines are giving immunity up to the percentage of 80 to 90%. None is, as of now, out of these two, none is claiming 100% immunity. They are giving immunity about 80 to 90%. That is the best one can think of at the moment, because let us understand the history that in the short period, this vaccine has been developed. RNA vaccines had not been developed so far. This was the first time an RNA vaccine was developed. And obviously, there are lots of ifs and buts. Experience is also not there. And that is why the protocols are being revised on day-to-day basis, depending upon the feedback which we are getting from various quarters. So ICMR and Government of India keeps on revising the protocols. Don't be surprised by that, because tomorrow something else may also be provided to you, given to you, follow that rule. But yes, the good thing is that they are constantly monitoring. And both these vaccines, they don't have any significant side effect. That means significant when I say, I mean that life-threatening. There is no life-threatening side effect has been noticed, and this has been very closely monitored. Now, if I just enumerate the side effects of Covaxin, basically it is fever, malaise, headache, pain at the injection site, or some swelling or itching, in some cases, nausea and vomiting. So these are all minor symptoms, I would say. Fever patients, in one-to-one variation is there. Some patients don't get any fever. Some get fever for 2, 3 days, 4 days. But generally, and the treatment for this fever is very simple. You have to pop in the tablet of paracetamol, crocin, and just take rest. Generally, all these symptoms will settle. In case when we come to Covishield, pain and tenderness at the point of injection is there. Headache is there. Tiredness is there. Tiredness means malaise, which was there in that. Here also the malaise is there. Muscle and joint pain is slightly more in this case of Covishield. Fever with chills is there in this, but and nausea is also there. So fever and chill and joint pain, these are two things which are more in case of Covishield. Sputnik, we don't have much experience. We'll go by the whatever data international body has provided to us. So now what to do? When to take? As I said, whenever you get your opportunity. Now, who should not take? Everybody should take the vaccine wherever possible. People with history of allergy should notify their team, doctors, that they have a strong history of allergy, and due precautions will be taken. After vaccination, you don't have to leave the site immediately. Stay there for at least half an hour. And before you leave the site, note down the number of the vaccination coordinator there. In case you have any serious problem which you want to discuss with the doctor there, you should call that number. So whenever you go to a site of vaccination, there the person, the number is displayed of the vaccination coordinator, which is to be noted. After you get COVID infection, what should be the gap between the vaccination? Are there? At least 3 months. At least 3 months you should take, because we feel that once you have an infection, your body generates some antibodies and we don't want to waste them. So we'll give vaccine 3 months after that, so that you get another 6 to 8 months or 9-10 months for the antibodies to be there in the body. The gaps between the two doses we have mentioned for both the vaccines. After COVID, patients with diabetes, hypertension, even they can take it, they should not. Only group which is contraindicated as of now in India is children less than 18 years, because we don't have any data of these vaccines being used in children. And the government of India is taking due precaution that nobody should suffer. The USA Moderna vaccine and Pfizer vaccine, they are trying these in children, and we will have to wait for the results. Let us see what happens. Now, how do you prevent infection in the children then? One, don't expose them unnecessarily. Second, all the adult members of the family who are moving out of the house, they should be properly vaccinated, and there should be enough time. It's not that today you have received a vaccination, tomorrow you are having antibodies. I made it very clear, it takes few weeks for antibodies to develop, for you to have protection. Now, let's understand another aspect of it. Once you are having antibodies, do you, can you spread infection? Very question. Correction, not in all cases. Patients who have good antibodies, generally they transmission to other. The moment it comes in contact with their body, it is able to handle the virus and destroy the virus. But the standard precautions which we have been discussing from the very beginning last year, social distancing, hand washing, masks, this is must, and you must continue even after vaccination. There are some reports from USA where they have allowed people who have been already vaccinated, they may not use masks. But in India, we can understand the circumstances. If you allow some people not to use the mask, everybody will stop using the mask. And we don't want third wave in our country. We cannot afford it. Already, everybody has suffered a lot, personally, as well as financially. So this was about it. And I hope you people know how to use the COVID website, how to take appointments. It's a very small app which is there. You can open it and it's a very simple, go step-wise. The guidance is there in the app itself. Must learn how to use that app, and you can take an appointment, go for vaccination as early as possible without further delay when it is available, whenever it is available. I know that there is a scarcity in the market, some created by the vested interest. But I hope that in next 2 months, a significant portion of our population gets vaccinated. So I think that was the introduction about this. And now we can go for question and answer session by the audience, by the participants.
Okay, sir, there's a question which one of the attendees had asked. So he's asking, what are the precautions we take after taking the first dose of vaccination?
You continue to take the precautions, the three precautions which you mentioned, social distancing, mask, and hand washing or sanitization. Immediately after taking the vaccine, don't exert too much. If necessary, take a little rest. If you feel feverish, if you feel malaise, take a little rest. If the fever is a little more, take a tablet of crocin, paracetamol. And that is the only precaution you have to take.
Okay. There's another question which person has asked, attendees has asked is, so when the person take the vaccine after having COVID-19?
3 months. 3 months gap I mentioned.
So the person has to take the second vaccine, well, the first vaccine or the second vaccine after 3 months. So what about the person has already taken first dose and he has met with the COVID? And then what the gap between the second dose? 3 months?
Same. 3 months. Same 3 months. Principle applies. And I can assure you, most of the people, 99% people who have taken first dose of vaccine, and there has been a gap of 3 weeks to 6 weeks between that and in getting infection. The chances of having a full-blown disease is very, very remote.
Okay, there's another question from Mr. Pankaj. So, what if one doesn't get the second dose in the gap period, that is Covishield, a gap of 3 months, and for the Covaxin, 4 to 5 weeks? Will this gap be voluntary or COVID infection?
You can take the vaccine as soon as it is available and take it as a second dose. other precaution which you can take after this is 4 weeks to 6 weeks after the second dose, you can get your antibody titer done. If you have a good antibody titer, you can be very comfortable. The research on mixing the vaccines has started in India just now, and we'll know the results of it in next few weeks, maybe 4 to 6 weeks.
So the same question Mr. Dennis Edwin and asked is, can the vaccine be mixed? So I think so you have already given.
Yes, so the answer as you see, as I said, it takes 4 to 6 weeks for antibodies to develop. Okay. I don't think there will be any complication because most of these vaccines, they have a different way of working. Somebody takes the RNA, somebody takes the shell of it, somebody makes a live virus and attenuates it, that way makes it ineffective, but the protein part is there. So ultimately, my personal feeling is that we will have a boost of antibodies with this. But yes, the best answer is if you have a good antibody titer, which can be done by any good lab, you will feel comfortable that yes, my body has some resistance to this virus.
Okay, there's another question by Mr. Veju. Can a person who had taken vaccine be a carrier?
Very unlikely. If the antibodies are good, very unlikely he can be a carrier, as I mentioned. But yes, he still has to take precaution because you need not carry virus from market to your house only through mouth or nose. You can carry it on your clothes. You can carry it on your hands. So those precautions, the standard precautions of hygiene, personal hygiene, taking precaution before entering your house, changing clothes as you go into your house, it has to be taken care of. But people have become lax. I have seen many patients, attendant, given an opportunity, they will enter the COVID ward. They should not do it.
Vivekji, we have to take the question from the Q&A box as well. I'm sure they have been also waiting for it. So I think we can hold on to some questions from the chat box and we can pick from the Q&A box now.
So there's a question about Dr. Captain Rajesh has asked, that double mask or single mask is enough? If this is through droplets, why single mask is not effective?
Mask has to be properly applied. The best way of knowing a mask has been properly applied is, as you put the mask on, as you take a breath, the mask should move inwards, and as you release your breath, the mask should move outwards. Double mask is an extra precaution, and I give credit to double mask for controlling this second wave of infection so early in many states. I saw rickshaw pullers, I saw cycle, they were all wearing 2 masks at least. There is no harm in using 2 masks. 1 mask applied properly, wash and change properly, it can serve the purpose. But since it is a droplet infection, having 2 masks, there is no harm in it.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Another question which Mr. Srinivas has asked, can breastfeeding mother take vaccines?
So far, we don't have any data about pregnancy and breastfeeding mother. So it has not been recommended or it has been given a clean chit. Its question mark is still there. But patients have become pregnant with COVID and they have carried on with the pregnancy and they have delivered normal baby. So that means the antibody which was there. But yes, giving a virus vaccine to a pregnant woman has always been questioned.
Okay, Mr. Amit Kaul has asked a question. After first dose, if person become COVID, then how much time another dose is required to be taken?
3 months.
Yeah, 3 months.
3 months from the date you become symptomatic or you become negative. Best is to take 3 months after you have become negative, RT-PCR or rapid test.
So any specific reason? Because initially there was a 1 month period of 4 weeks initially, and suddenly because of the shortage of the vaccine, the date, the duration of...
No, one should not take it that way. Covaxin, we are still recommending early, but the body after the infection is there. Body develops its own antibodies.
Okay.
And that is the reason why this time factor has been declared. And very recently it has been declared. I would say, I think in last week or so. But still the better way, if you want to be doubly sure, is to go for an antibody titer.
Okay, thank you. Another question from Mr. Dharmesh. is that after testing COVID positive, do we need negative RT-PCR report?
No, as of now, no.
Okay. Another question is that I have taken steroid past 4 years back due to GBS. Can I take the vaccine now as suffering from muscle pain?
You can take vaccine, but tell your doctor, he will keep you under better observation.
Okay, thank you. Another question is, after vaccination, what we need to eat, what to not, and how much days?
No restrictions.
Okay.
Unless you want to feel happy that you have restricted yourself. Otherwise, a good diet, high protein diet, fresh fruits. This is the general recommendation in a COVID phase.
Okay. The another question from Captain Rajesh is, how much is the probability of people suffering by COVID even after taking the both medicines?
As I said, 90% they will not get it, or 95% they will not get it. Even if they get 1 or 2%, the severity of the disease will not be there. Very few cases, they have progressed. Maybe they did not develop antibodies, and that is why the disease progressed to that level. Very, very few cases. Less than 0.03%.
Okay. The severity is not much.
Yes. That is the advantage.
Okay. So another question from Mr. Dharmendra is, even after 21 days, he is getting positive RT-PCR report.
He can take continue to take rest, because RT-PCR report test is not recommended by ICMR these days. Only thing is, when you travel and all those things, they insist. RT-PCR test is based on the virus proteins, and even the dead virus which is there in your nose and mouth, that can also give a positive report.
Okay. Another question from Mr. Devinder ji is, what are the tests for knowing status or state of antibodies in your body after vaccination?
Best is antibody titer.
Okay.
Antibody titer is the answer. That gives you a confidence, yes. Like I am having an antibody titer of 150. This was done last month. 6 weeks after my second dose of vaccine. And I have been working, despite my age and diabetic status, I have been working in the COVID ward in this session, at least the second session of this COVID, and very comfortably, because I felt that I have a good antibody titer.
Okay. Another question from Mr. Amit is that, what food do doctor recommend after a person becomes negative, as it is found that a lot of weakness, body pain observed?
Fruit. You mentioned fruit.
Food. Yeah.
Food, high protein diet is recommended, definitely. A significantly high for vegetarians, it is paneer and soya bean. For non-veg, eggs are a very good source, but good quality eggs. And all the meats are there good. And fruits, of course, are recommended, fresh fruits. So the diet generally has, you have to increase your calorie intake also. Because once you had COVID, you must have lost significant weight. 3 to 5 kg weight generally patients lose if they have a serious illness. If they don't have serious illness, they don't lose weight. So 3 to 5 kg weight, if you eat a little more, it has to recover also. And it will give you enough energy to fight the weakness which is there.
Vivekji, can we move to the chat box now?
Yeah.
Thank you. We have to start from the Sadanand Deshmukh.
Yeah. Sadanand asked, do we need to take another dose? I mean, third dose after second dose?
We don't know.
Okay. Some booster kind of thing will be there, or no idea, sir?
Time will tell. We don't know. As of now, you see, this is the first time RNA vaccine has been made, and lots of ifs and buts are there. So monitoring is being done by WHO. Monitoring is done by the countries also. The various medical bodies are done, and the data is pooled, and recommendations are given according to that. So let us not go by the political advice. The advice has to be technical, and we should go by technical advice. No political interference in this vaccination program. That is my request, because they have already made a mess of the whole program.
Okay. Okay, the other question from Mr. Santosh is that both dose of vaccine will remain active antibodies for once in a life?
No. No.
Okay. So the another question from Shreya is how to recognize that the vaccine has affected or start working in your body? Are there any symptoms after getting
vaccine? No symptoms. No symptoms. The only way, as I mentioned, getting the antibody titer done.
Okay. And Dr. Monica has asked, when will the vaccine will be available for kids?
America is doing the study, as we mentioned. India has yet not started any trial in this particular direction. Even America is doing only up to 16 years of age. Other kids, that's a very, very controlled study. So maybe it will take 2, 3 months, 6 months before we come to this.
Okay. The Major Shubhra has asked, is N95 mask a must or we can do with cloth mask?
Cloth mask, good, of fair thickness, they are good enough. Only thing is keep on changing the mask very frequently. Many people were using N95 mask for 7 days. That is also not recommended because the mask will definitely going to get contaminated. Mask is not going to kill the virus. Mask is just acting as a filter.
Okay. Another question from Dr. Monica is that also does the vaccine reduce the chance of spreading the virus?
Yes, vaccine is going to. That is why, despite knowing that only 80 to 90% people will develop antibody, we want the society to be vaccinated because this is the only way you are going to break the chain of infection, what you know as herd immunity, either by disease or by this becoming a non-symptomatic sufferer of the infection or by vaccination. So once a good percentage of the population has immunity, we hope that the disease will get controlled.
Okay, another question from Mr. Pankaj is, what do you mean by antibodies titer? How it works and its process?
I explained in the beginning that once we give an antigen, once we give a vaccine, or the body gets infected by this virus, body starts reacting. So antigen leads to antibody formation. Antibody formation is a natural immunity. We vaccinate all our children for polio. We vaccinate them for typhoid. We vaccinate them for diphtheria. In all these cases, antibodies develop. That is why they get resistant to the disease. That is why we were able to control the diseases like polio, diphtheria, and tetanus.
Okay. The another question from Mr. Devendra is, what are the tests required to check antibodies developed after vaccination and after how many days?
Yeah. I recommend at least 6 weeks or so.
Okay. Another question from Pushpanjali is, why so thought even after first dose vaccine?
Why?
Sore throat even after first dose of vaccine.
Sore throat can develop for any reason.
Okay.
It can develop for any reason, but yes, if it is vaccine induced, it will last for a few couple of days only.
Okay. So Renu Sharma has asked one question. She is asking, my husband suffering high BP, corona recovery last month, vaccine not done. Any test or checkup important?
You see, he has been under treatment of a physician. I will recommend he should continue under the guidance of that physician. He had, as you mentioned, he had COVID infection also. Yeah. Yeah, so he should be under guidance of that physician and no self-medication in this case.
So Mr. Devin Singh, what is the validity of vaccine or what would be the frequency? I think they have already explained it. So when we...
I think most of the questions we have
questions
taken...
are repeated, yeah.
Yes, they are being repeated now.
So Mr. Ashok Prabhakar asked, what are the chances of passing virus by someone who had taken both jabs?
I would say very less, but it cannot be ruled out.
So the another question from Mr. Amit Kaul is that as news are coming for third wave and that will be not good for children, is this true or rumor? If it is true, then what precautions should parents take for children?
This is not rumor. This is based on the epidemiological analysis of the disease pattern from the past experience. There is a group of scientists in medical profession. They are called epidemiologists. They study the pattern of disease, how it spreads. And we very well know that this virus, all virus, in fact, they mutate very strongly. They mutate very fast. That means they keep on changing the character. So only thing we hope is that the mutant virus is still sensitive to the vaccine. And prevent spread to the children, the best ways is parents should be properly vaccinated. Children should not be exposed. They should continue to stay at home. And the precautions, standard precautions, which I mentioned, they should be taken. And persons who are moving out of the house, in and out of the house, they should be controlled. And once they come to the house, they should take a proper bath or change the clothes, wash hands, and then only interact with the children.
Thank you. So another question from Mr. Shetty is, what should be the antibodies level post-COVID and post-vaccination?
See, it can be anywhere. 10 to 20, 25, 30. We have seen various range, up to 5,000 I have seen.
Okay, Mr. Abhijit Roy is asking, what is the herd immunity and how does it prevent further spread?
Herd immunity is that a majority of the population has immunity for the virus, and this immunity prevents the lodging of the virus in the that particular person. So this breaks the chain of the spread. Like we know, this virus was spreading from one to another person to another person to another person. Out of these 10 persons, suppose 6 have got immunity or 7 have got immunity, and they come in between the chain. So infection will not pass from one to another person. And the virus, since it has a life span of its own, it is going to die down unless it gets transmitted to the other. So this is what we call herd immunity, that when a good percentage of the population has resistance to the virus, that is antibodies.
Okay, one more question. Mr. Deepak is asking, my father has gone through heart bypass surgery 8 years back.
Okay.
My friend has gone through heart bypass surgery 8 years back. Can she take the vaccine?
Yes, they should take the vaccine.
Okay. The another question is, please let us know more about latest white, black and yellow fungus.
Okay, I'll come to that. Let's go back to the first question. That is heart disease. Since this injection is given intramuscular, where all the patients who are on blood thinners, that is anticoagulants, they should be cautious about it and they should let the doctor know that they are on blood thinners so that they take adequate precaution, whosoever is giving the vaccine. Now, coming back to the fungus issue. Fungus definitely is an offshoot of the infection, use of steroids, and incidentally, high humidity in last few days, that is almost a month, that we are having a wet weather and there is a lot of this. Now these fungal fungal spores, they were there in the atmosphere all the time. That is why you might have noticed that when you leave the bread in your kitchen exposed for 2-3 days, it develops a mold. All this fungal infection we are talking about is mold. They have different characters, different types are there, just like so many viruses are there, so many bacteria are there. You have noticed that on the waste, which is wet waste, which is lying on the various dumping sites, you have seen mushrooms growing, those cucurbits. They are also fungus. So these spores, since they are very thin and they spread by the air, the moment they find an opportunistic place where they can grow easily, and that opportunistic place is where the temperatures are not very high, where the humidity is high, and the body resistance is weak. Body resistance is weak for various reasons. One, steroids, which were part of the essential therapy in COVID. Second, patients who are on chemotherapy. Third, patients who are suffering from other major diseases like malignancies and all those things.
Okay, Mr. Dennis has asked, COVID symptoms are just like any flu. So how do we identify if it is a COVID symptom apart from testing?
That is the nuisance of this virus, that it comes so quietly and it spreads so fast because we tend to take it lightly. the recommendation right from day one has been, the moment you get sore throat or fever or any related or loss of smell or loss of taste, get yourself tested and isolate. Even before testing, you must isolate for the sake of your family and your children. Don't go to office and then get tested after 4 days. And then, I have spread it to so many people also.
Okay, another question is, what is the official isolation period or days for COVID infected person?
15 days or so. From the date to test positive. That is what officially they accept now.
Thank you. Mr. Dennis is asking, COVID patients are just like any flu. So how do we identify it is the COVID symptoms apart from testing?
I answered that question just now.
Thank you.
Testing is the only way. And you have to be careful that in a particular area or particular period when the disease incidence is high, the chances are we go by the other way, that all these flus are COVID positive. Unless proved otherwise. And the other thing we must learn also, that both these tests, RT-PCR and rapid antigen test, they have a positivity rate of only 70 to 80%. That means they have a chance of missing even 20%. That is why we are unable to control this virus despite testing. Because people who are not severely ill, but who are carrying the virus, they spread it to others. And we fail to take precaution. We try to be smart. We want to continue with our work. We don't want to get tested, and this virus came with a bang second time. So this was a mutant strain which was there. Mutant means the character of the virus changed, and it spread like anything. This phase two, the spread of virus, the mutancy was such that it can spread from one person to another, and it was said 10 times more than the phase one. That is why so many cases were there this time.
Okay, any question? Please write on the chat box.
I think we've got this official isolation period days for COVID infected person.
Like you mentioned, 15 days.
15 days.
Yeah.
Covered. Yeah.
Okay. And what we really need to do for to stay away from these latest fungal infections.
See, these fungal infections don't occur in ordinary patients. They occur in patients who are on heavy doses of steroid, who are in ICU. Not in a person who is moving around or who had a COVID and who was in home isolation. Very, very rare that these things are happening. And you see, if we had gone by the technical advice, we wouldn't have suffered that much. We were told to start steroids on the 7th or 8th day. People started using steroid from the day one. They had symptoms. So we asked for problem.
So I think so we have just covered all the questions.
I'm not sure. Maybe I have missed it, but there is still one question which I see there, which says, what do you mean by antibody titan and how it works and its purpose, please?
We covered it, Jatin.
Okay.
We covered it. I'll repeat it if you want. You see, these titers can be from very low to very high, depending upon the individual response. My opening sentence was, our antibodies develop in response to the virus, which is an antigen. All invasions in our body are taken as antigens, whether it is typhoid or polio or jaundice or all these things. So these are antigens of different types. So for each different antigen, our body reacts and creates its own antibody. So these titers, we can check. We can check and we know. I have seen in patients who, after the disease, had titer of 10. I have seen patients who, after the vaccination, had titer of 2,000. So the variation is very low. And if you have seen the report today, somewhere in UP, somebody has filed a case against Serum Institute. They have filed a FIR, and the case has not been filed, that I took both the doses of Covishield, but still my antibody titer is zero. I don't think anybody is to be blamed for, unless he has been vaccinated by that nurse from Agra who was pricking the people but not injecting the vaccine. So I hope you must have read it. It was in yesterday's paper. And this case filing has been in today's paper. So these things keep on happening. And medical world has to be cautious about it. but you on your own also have to be equally cautious that this nurse who could do this in 29 patients in a row, I don't know how many she did before this, but why she did, we don't know. She explanation she gave was, I was mentally upset. So she was loading the vaccine in the syringe, pricking the person, but not injecting inside the person.
Okay, the another question is that, do we need repeated vaccinations?
As of now, only 2 doses have been recommended.
Okay, Mr. Sadanand has asked a question. The co-vaccine vaccine taken people can't travel abroad. Is this rumor or is it?
No, that's a fact. WHO has not approved this vaccine in its list. So when it comes to international travel, this rule will apply. But hopefully, I think they have to submit some data on this. Once that data is submitted, because you see, all these things were done in a hurry. The vaccine was produced and it was given to patients. Safety was the first thing which they did. Getting approvals from international body was the second thing. So we found that Covaxin was fairly safe. It was, you see, we have used it for 5 months now. No major side effect has been reported with this vaccine, and patients have shown antibodies with this vaccine. So now, as mentioned by ICMR, that they are submitting the data, the government, these people will submit the data, and WHO hopefully will give approval to it. Once that approval is given, you can travel.
Okay, sir. Another question from Devendra is, when next vaccine is required after completing 2 doses of vaccination?
As of now, no third dose is required.
Okay. Major Shubhra is asking, generally one vial of Covishield has 10 doses, but
right,
you are given 11 or 12 doses per vial also. Can this happen?
It can be 11 doses, not 12 doses, because the vaccine in each vial is more than 10 ml. More than 10 doses. That is why, if you remember, the Kerala reported 105 to 110% usage of vaccine. And in some rogue states, the usage was 90% or 80%. The wastage was to that extent. Kerala had a very good health minister at that time, Madam Shailja, and she had motivated her staff to do the best possible, and they delivered 105 to 110% usage of the vaccine.
So I think hopefully we have covered all questions, and I think so.
If anything still is there, you can send me a message and I will answer that. But I think we have covered almost all the queries which generally people have. Now, individual cases may be left around, but I would still recommend, go to your physician who has been regularly, but don't crowd in the hospital. You can go for a telephone consultation with the physician who has been treating you.
Sir, I want to ask a question.
Yeah, please.
Sir, a diabetic person, especially, he has to take any special precaution for a already the diabetic person is, his immunity is quite low. So any special thing he has to take care regarding this COVID?
Must have. First thing is, take a vaccine. Second, when you take this vaccine injection, please keep your sugar level under control. And there are so many medicines now, you can keep your sugar level under control. Because I don't want you to develop an abscess at the site of infection if your sugar levels are high.
Okay. I think there's a lot of questions which will be answered. We have Captain Rajesh, who is from the governing board of GSE Association. I would like to say something. Over to you, Captain.
Thank you, Jatin. And first of all, thank you so much, sir. These may sound like very, very basic questions, but like you said, most of the common people, they have these questions in mind. And okay. I was also feeling that there were a few questions which were like repetitive, but I think the curiosity is so much. One really wants to be very, very clear. Because this is about the health of the family members as well as individuals. But I'm so pleasantly glad that the way you responded and patiently you heard everyone. I think hats off to you. Thank you so much.
Seriously,
like I said, for you, these may be very, very basic questions what people are asking, but on a day-to-day basis, there is so much of rumor, and you're right. Like, there are so many political, so to say, messaging being done at different social media levels. So people get confused. In spite of them hearing from horse's mouth that this is the right way, still there are 20 more messages coming in saying that probably this is also one way, and people get confused. So, but the way you, I think, explained and the way you answered, that's really great. So thank you so much. On behalf of complete GACS, we would like to once again thank you for your time and your advice, guidance. If still there are any so-called, I'll not say questions, but doubts in people's mind, we'll consolidate, we'll request your time, and maybe we can reach out to
anytime. Anytime. You see, the human psychology is like that we tend to black out also at the time when we are listening, and anxiety levels are there. And since the majority of our population is uneducated, I would still say effectively educated, so they believe in rumors and political messages more than the technical messages.
Oh, absolutely, sir. You're bang on. You are right. You gave the example of rickshawalas and all wearing double masks because they hear and they follow. The problem is people like us, because they have so many other ways and means on social media. In spite of hearing from the competitive authorities, there are so many messages which come in, people get confused. So I always say, guys, don't look at all these things. And I think today we have clarified a lot of such doubts or queries which we all had. So that's all. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
Over to Jatin.
Again, thank you so much, Dr. Bharat. It's been really nice. We've been getting a lot of comments, a lot of appreciation. And I think this is a need of our, which we all have been looking for. And you've been quite patient enough, as Captain rightly said.
Patience. It's my profession. There has to be patience.
Yeah. Absolutely. And this is something that we should also learn it from you. So thank you once again. Thank you all the participants for joining. We'll come back with more sessions like this. Please do take care of yourself. Wear mask. Maintain distance. Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you,
sir.
Good night. Good night, everyone.